The mighty Aru Falls in Pader District. As attractive as this gem may be, not many people visit or even know about it. It's the same story as that of many other tourist attractions not explored in the north. This neglect results in lost revenue from potential tourists. Daniel Irunga, an official from the Ministry of Tourism, acknowledges these issues. He reveals that the government is committed to gazetting and developing these attractions while exploring opportunities for public-private partnerships.
Throughout our campaign, we've realized the need for PPP, private-public sector partnerships. And that's one of the strategies we'll take to develop some of these sites.
The recently concluded Explore North expedition, following the success of the Explore Elgon and Explore West caravans, played a crucial role in raising awareness of local tourism.
This has been the first of the kind where tour operators have been involved, and we appreciate Ministry of Tourism. It's a success. I can call it a success because we've learned a lot from it. We've managed to network with the tourism sector bosses. We've always heard of them.
Led by the State Minister for Tourism, a group of Ugandan tourists explored sites such as the Karuma Falls, Aru Falls, Fort Patiko, and Nyabieya Heritage Site. The expedition aimed to bolster local tourism and unlock the full potential of tourist attractions across the country.
People should be able to come from Kampala and travel and continue supporting the sector. So that, like the other sisters were saying, so that Toto can be able to buy the chicken from the local person, the person will get some fees, you'll keep the 30 employees here, so that we keep the sector alive so it doesn't collapse because of these interferences.
During the same expedition, the minister announced that the government is allocating 800 million shillings for the development of Aru Falls. The funds will be used for the construction of walkways, reception areas, and necessary facilities for visitors.
Now, in the next financial year, this one that is starting, we have 800 million shillings we are going to inject in Aru Falls in this coming financial year. And hopefully we'll continue adding money over the years to make this the best. At least we've been there ourselves, we've seen there are issues of access, there are issues of safety, and we'll see how this money can help us resolve some of those issues. It may not be enough, but like I'm saying, at least we will start.
The minister also emphasized the positive impacts of the Explore Uganda project, saying that local tourists in 2022 increased as evidence of its success.
That the responsibility of marketing the beautiful power of Africa is a responsibility of not me as a minister, not someone in the business like Otto, not the RCC, but it is a responsibility of every Ugandan.
Despite the sector's recent success, private tour operators represented by Robert Okwera urge the government to collaborate with them to drive the tourism agenda. They also request land within national parks to develop hotels and other facilities, along with the reduction or exemption from high taxes.
They are so high, like you have your car company trying to, make ends meet, and the taxes are very high. They actually sometimes fail us. You find when you've fallen out of business because of high taxes.
Kenyana Sarah Rosoke, Miss Tourism Rwenzori, expresses her enthusiasm for the tour, highlighting the incredible experiences and encouraging everyone to visit these remarkable sites.
And this particular trip has been enlightening, not just for other people but for me as well, even though I've been moving around quite a bit. So I think it has been a very enlightening experience and one that everybody should have really been a part of.
We are also encouraging Ugandans to love this country more. We are so blessed. River Nile is the longest in Africa and in the world.
According to Uganda Investment Authority, tourism contributes 7.7% to the gross domestic product. This story was compiled by Godi Sempija for the news.